page 3. Page 3. So I cut this quarter circle off one of the 12 by 12s. And I'm going to make a side pocket. So I'm going to glue this down and then just free cut the arc. And I've got two of the four sides folded. So it's going to go in the left corner of page 3. Left corner of page 3. So this will have tape. So now I'm just going to trim like so. So I'm going to take my bone folder. I'm going to trace it. This will leave a slight indentation that when I hold it just right in the light, I can follow it and cut my paper. Let's see if I can get, did I get enough of it? I didn't. I'm going to put it on something a little bit softer like this magazine. I have foam, but I don't want to get it out. It's not handy. Okay. Now I can see it. It's faint, but I can see it. So I'm just going to follow that. You can use a bone folder, the back end of a pen, the back end of anything that's got a tip on it. Usually if it's a rectangle or a circle, I'll use one of my tools because it does a better job. But this is what I do to fussy cut complicated elements. Like if especially like something like this, if it had a ton of detail, I would trace it and hand cut it. And so it helps. I mean, it's not perfect. You can see I got a little shallow here, but it helps. Okay, I'm gonna add some tape and we'll add this to the book. So this is a simple page, just this side pocket and an insert. I liked using these arced and circular features in the book because of all the planets. It just seems to go together. Okay, where did I put? Here it is. Page 3. Okay. Okay. So this is going to go right here. Like so. I'm going to put a dot of glue right here where I didn't get tape. Just making sure it's right side up. So any quarter circle would work. Whichever color is most interesting to you. This is the image that's going to go in the background. And it's always kind of hard to tuck it in. So you can do a couple of things. One, you can trace the circle and cut away part of it. I like to leave the whole thing intact. I'm going to trim this down. And then what I'll do is this leading edge that's going into the pocket won't have glue on it. All of this will. And it'll tuck into the pocket, and the pocket will hold the part that's not glued in place. And that'll all be a little bit clearer in just a second. Okay, now what I did was I trimmed, this was 8x8, I trimmed it to 7 7/8 by 7 7/8. There you go. And it'll fit. Just like so. So I'm going to go ahead and ink it. again, we're going to keep this corner glue free. And it's from the background. I would have seen this one with this strong image. I would have guessed it was from the collection pack. I'm starting to wonder if I had it. Everything I've been telling you is from backgrounds. I'm starting to wonder if I have the collection packs. I must have. I wrote my material list down somewhere, so I'll go back to it. Okay, I'm going to start by pushing the corner in, getting around my two flanges that are holding our pocket in place. Make sure it's well seated, and then we'll back it out if we need to. But looks like it went down pretty straight. Looks pretty good. Okay, now here's our insert. This is from the background. It's going to go in here. I'm going to add something on the top, like a little tab. One of the chipboard pieces. I think I'll use this. Nope, too big. That's the problem I'm having with the set of chipboard that I selected to use. They're too big. That disappears. I like this a little bit better. Let me see. What about? Let's do that. That's fun. So it'll just be just like a little tab on a tag. Wow, my language is escaping me. I haven't talked to anybody all day, you guys. I bet some of you know a little bit about that. All right, that's page 3. Nice, simple, clean. Later on, you can add more inserts depending on what paper we have left over, but I wanted to at least preserve one nice size for this because it's such a simple page. It definitely needed a large insert. So. This is page 3. The arc, the way I've done it, the arc is toward the spine, and it just happened that this was a scrap that I had cut off from one of the others, so instead of waste it, I'm using it right here. Not waste, but I'm making good use of it. Okay, make sure all my corners are down. That's it. Okay, I'll be back soon with more pages.